Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting video tutorial today. And in this video, I'm going to talk about how can you debug the OmniScript or flex card in runtime mode. Now, if you're using OmniStudio for your development, chances are you're working on a lot of UI components and you must be using OmniScript or flex card. Now, let's take an example about basically where I'm going before I want to go into the solution. You have an OmniScript, and in this OmniScript, you have some, you're calling some actions. Let's say you're calling an Apex class or you're calling an integration procedure. Now this Apex class or integration or any basically action accepts some parameters. So you are sending some data basically. For example, this is my OmniScript, and in this OmniScript I have this integration procedure called mock data, and I'm basically, you know, passing some of these values. I have basically, let's say, a couple of formulas here, and I'm passing this formula data. Now, to get the data exactly what data I'm passing in this date value or random value, I can always go to the preview section. Okay, I'm just gonna clear this log. I have this data JSON here. You can see I have date value, random value, and if I click this IP action here, okay, I can get one block here, and inside this I can always see the request data. Now this is all pretty much most of the time we have to debug even in flexcard as well. If you whatever your source is there, you just need to, you know, create a request for that integration procedure or Apex class or any action, and you just have to figure out. But this is what happens when you have access to the designer, and in runtime mode it's really difficult to debug like this. So what we can do is we can always go to this inspect element here, okay, and you can see we have some network tab. So inside, so whenever you are going to do any action, any server call that happens from your OmniScript or flexcard, there's always going to be a network request here. So if I click on this IP action, is the exact same one that I'm calling from here, which I get, okay, here. So if I click on this button, you can see we have R37 something, and probably it's a revision, or it's an incremental number, and you can see we have this message here, and then we have response as well. So this is the response that I'm getting from my IP, okay, and this is nothing but the data. So if I just copy this and just paste it here, okay, if I format this, you can see we have this input that we are passing, and then we have pretty much what our IP is. Now it's really difficult to figure out exactly, you know, which network request we have, because for example, if I just refresh this right now, I'm gonna have like hundreds and 200s of network requests, and if I click this button here somewhere, it's just difficult for me to figure out what is happening, okay, because again there are, like you can see, you have 100 and 200s of requests. It's really difficult like that. So that's why you should always clear this. And if I, after clearing, if we just execute it, we'll definitely find that one particular request. Okay, now this is one way to figure out what is on the basis of action or any event that is happening. But what if in this OmniScript, I want to also figure out what is the Omni data JSON. Now this is a complete data JSON for this OmniScript. This is like the part two. So for this, there is not really a shortcut. All you have to do is basically, you see, every single time there's going to be a step, okay, on the OmniScript. So whenever you find a step, okay, what you have to do, you always have to use this cursor here, and make sure you're hovering on the step here, and whenever you find velocity underscore cmt, if it's a velocity managed package, so you'll always find OmniScript dash step here component, and you just have to right click. And then you have option, as if you're using Google Chrome, most likely you'll see store as global variable. If you just do it, it's gonna save it as temp1. And to get a JSON, I need to just type temp1.json data. So if I hit this, I'm gonna get some object. Okay, I just have to copy this object, and hopefully if I just paste it here, okay, this is what the data I'm getting. So the step one, person key, all this data, okay, all this data which I was getting in this Omni JSON is exactly the same data JSON. So these are the two ways that you can debug the OmniScript pretty much, and same thing you can debug in flexcard as well. Pretty much you have to figure out the network callouts. Now I have also created another, so now I spend a lot of time on this kind of things, and I always try to figure out how can I automate it, how can I make it better. So I have created an extension called OmniStudio Network Logger. So it logs for OmniScripts and FlexCard. For example, if I click this IP action here, okay, you can see it is logging. Which action is this? This is an integration procedure. So this is a mock data, is nothing but my IP name. What is the request that I have passed to my IP and what is the response I have received from the IP as well? If it's a apex method, it's also gonna log, okay, what is the apex class? Let's say it's generic util dot generate is the method, and this is the input and this is my output. So pretty much this is a very basic thing I have created for now to just get the logs, because again I don't want to go through all these logs and then basically figure out, okay, what is my what is action and what is the request, what is the response for that. So the best way is I always use this OmniStudio Network Logger, and currently we have almost 300 plus active users. If you want, you can definitely go through this. I have also added a LinkedIn article on this, so you can go through the LinkedIn article, and I'll see you in the next video.